Hello everyone and welcome to From the Depths. Now today we are going to see a ship that, let's face it, it's not mine. But I think it's just so too cool, not so. Now I say it's not mine, the modifications and the armament and a lot of things on it are mine, actually. Now the story is this ship, or the base of it, was posted some days ago in the From the Depths forum. In the Blueprints subforum, a guy called Darth Gunn, posted what he had built, a wooden fast transport craft. Now the craft itself was really beautiful, and I was surprised when he said he was achieving only 18 knots out of it. Turned out to be he meant 18 meters per second, but even then, the shape of the craft in the pictures was super aerodynamic, and it was really, really, really surprised he only could get that out of it. So I suggested him to, well, put some propellers on it and to try to make it faster, and actually I did it myself. Now his original craft had obviously none of these torpedo launchers, and under the decks had a lot of, fuel and spaces for carrying supplies, as it was intended to be a transport and supply ship for the campaign. I changed a lot of that. We are going to see that in a second. The thing is, I made some modifications to the ship. We are going to see them. And I achieved 27 meters per second out of the same hull. And one of his comments left me thinking, because he said it was really kind of a pity to left something that fast without any weaponry. So that stuck on my mind, and for the last hours I've been toying with that design, thinking what it could be. And obviously without the speed it should be a very fast attack craft. Being very small, it couldn't be very well protected, so its main defense would be the speed. So I didn't put anything fancy in here. It has no shields, it has no guns, it has nothing but those torpedoes. But those torpedoes are really, really, really brutal. We are going to see that in a second. Let's take a look at the ship itself. Now again, well, I'm going to try to divide what's mine and what's from Darod. The cockpit is his, this computer, I place it here, these connectors, I place them here. If we drop down here, we see a couple of injector engines. Really, really elegant solution. They give enough power to use those propellers and a little bit more, which gave me the room to improve it the way I did. For over here we have the AI, which I added a couple of PIDs to it to make it more stable. Here he had a we can't really move ahead, well, whatever. Here he had, well, a lot of fuel tanks, a lot of stuff to transport materials, etc. I substituted, well, I took most of the fuel out, and I substituted the material transporters for some barely armored, because this is light alloy, this is not armor, but whatever, it's a bit of protection, for some ammo boxes. Now, ahead here we have a mainframe, which is independent from that one. This one controls the weapons are obviously the torpedoes. Has a target prioritization card, a mainframe, local weapon controller, and the missile controller. The missile controller is set to fire at an azimuth of minus 20 or plus 20. That means that the torpedoes only fire at targets ahead. The local weapon controller, I have it without range considerations at all, but I have it obviously set to not shoot at flyers. Now, above are the torpedo launchers, a grand total of 8. They are 6 long, and currently they are set up for engaging against Onyx Watch ships, because seriously, at this stage going against Deepwater Guard is a little bit easy for me. So also, the idea of this warship is to go very fast and avoid enemy fire, that you can do against things like cram cannons. Onyx Watch are specialized in that. If you are facing something with a big APS system, advanced projector system with very fast cells, yeah, things are a little bit more complicated, but it still works. It really does. Anyway, the torpedoes themselves, two propellers, they are very fast, they are very maneuverable, with two fins, two fuel tanks, very long range, ballast tanks, regulator for long range, three EMP warheads, and one torpedo sonar. The thing is, the if these torpedoes are going to go against deep water guard, you want those warheads to be explosive. But against Onyx Watch ships, you want those to be EMP, because Onyx ships are mostly made of metal, and they conduct very well EMP signals. If you hit an Onyx Watch ship enough with EMP, you are going to kill its mainframe, it's going to go AI dead, and you are going to win. They are all thrown via missile ejectors, and they are spaced out. What do I mean by that? Well, if I go back to the command room, there, and I take a seat, and we go up there and we select the weapons, if we fire them, you see they form an arc in front of us. Not only that, as they are ejected, they win a head start, which is really, really interesting. I initially did it to, well, clear them out of the race, but now it gets kind of a fun effect, which is really, really, really cool, and prevents me having to use target weapon guidance or something like that. This doesn't have any fancy stuff, no one turn, no target prediction guidance, no APN guidance, nothing. Only the torpedo sonar. As for detection goes, I also have to add something, because obviously being a transport seat, it have nothing. I placed the connectors directly attached to the mainframe, so I could put a wireless snooper and an IR camera. Both are passive systems with self-guided weapons. I really don't need pinpoint accuracy, so there's no point in that. Now, the other side, obviously, of detection is not being detected, and actually this ship does a very good job in not getting detected. Let's get to speed for a second. Again, slowly. There we go. Now, if we go to the signatures, well, we can see it's very small from the side, from the front. A little bit longer from the rear, can go almost 900 in the worst case scenario. Actually, when you are after a while going at this speed, it gets to 950 or something like that. But even then, it's not really big, I mean, only from behind. And you can see it's stabilizing at 900, so yeah. Visible range, well, obviously this is no submarine. And yeah, you can see it from pretty far away, but I mean there are some, obviously, some detection systems which rely on cameras, but those that rely on radar are going to have a really, really tough time tracking this thing. Very small ranges all around the place. The biggest from, yeah, as always, the diagonals, because it's where the biggest returns you are going to give. But from the inside, the front, etc., is very small. Sonar range as well is very small. The biggest one is from directly below, but even then, not very big, less than 1 kilometer. And wireless snoop range is zero, because all the connections are hardwired. I used no wireless signal in here. So as you can see, it's quite stealthy. And obviously, by stealthy, I don't mean that the enemies are not going to notice it, because they are going to see it. If they have some kind of visual tracking, normal cameras, They are going to see it and react to it. If they rely on heat or radar only and no visual means, it's going to be serious. And even with IR cameras, only from behind. So, yeah, they need cameras, like tracking devices using cameras. And even with those, I mean, the resolution they get is very, very small. If you get something, if you do something that the enemy can detect but can barely detect, their accuracy is going to be very, very bad. So, really stealthy design. The only problem, obviously, is that the enemy can see it. But yeah, there's a very, very limited amount of things you can do with a ship and not a submarine in regards to that. Other than that, very stealthy design. As for the modifications I did to the design itself, well, the initial design he put up, I think, had only these three propellers down here. Well, I went ahead and added a forward pod with another big thrusters and two aft pods with two big thrusters as well. On top of that, I added these anti-roll mechanisms, because at full speed, if you use this rudder, which is well behind below the center of mass, the thing tends to roll quite a lot. So those help with that via PID. And these are very interesting hydrofoils. Now, usually you use hydrofoils to stabilize a given ship. So what you want to do with them is to aim for a pitch of zero. I didn't aim for that. If you go to the PID, which is in here, and it's this one, it's set to a test stimulus of 5 degrees. That means that it's not trying to go balanced, it's trying to go nose up. And that has a purpose. Initially the ship didn't do this, this did after my modifications. If you start moving ahead, you have to be careful because this can perfectly go airborne when accelerating. Yeah, you really need a fine... Yeah, now we can go full thread. Yeah, there we go. Now you will see that these are going down, up, down, up, down, trying to keep a nose up attitude of 5 degrees. That way, we put the whole nose out of the water, we keep the thrusters under the water, we decrease the drag, and we are going to turn because yeah, we are about to run aground. You decrease the drag drastically because the nose is now producing no drag against the water, and you ensure that your thrusters are in the water, which is really, really good. The bad point of it, obviously, is that you have to be really careful when accelerating. As you saw, if you go from zero to full, you run the risk of turning your ship into a short-lived flyer, and you don't want that. But you can see that this thing tops is almost at 27 meters per second. It's a little bit slower because obviously I added quite a lot of weight in here. But the pure transport goes at 27 meters per second. This actually tops a little bit more than that. I have achieved 27.3 or something like that. Let me check. No, 26.9. Must have been one of the previous iterations. At any rate, you can see it's really cheap. 7,500. And you also can see that the drag goes up and down, but it's really, really, really small. So it's highly, highly, highly hydrodynamic underwater, and really pays off. I mean, the basic design was really good. There's not denying that. The ship was amazing on itself. But after the modifications, was much better because it was much faster. And now it's an actually surprisingly effective combatant. Now let's face it, this thing can't stand the heat. It has no subdivision, it has no internal compartments, but on the good side, it's very hard to hit because it's very small. It has no draft at all. As you can see, it's pretty much moving over the water, so any cells that fall short, they are not going to connect. And yeah, it really, really, really does the job very, very well. Let's test that, because, well, One more thing, the anti-roll mechanism works very well, as you can see, but you don't want to do a counter-turn. Because you, there's a problem with this, it didn't happen now, but it might happen that if you are turning, you are rolling a bit, not a lot, but you are rolling a bit. If you counter-turn, you run the risk, see the propellers down there. If it's too drastic and it's too fast, you might get this out of the water. If this gets out of the water, the ship is going to roll. So you have to be careful with that as well. It's a little finicky to toy with. I mean, you have to be careful not to accelerate too much from zero and not to do steep turns while you are turning. Also, while you are turning, after your release, it tends to correct a little bit to the other side. Something I don't really like a lot, but it's a direct consequence of the way these propellers work. But the thing is stable, it works like a charm, it's really cheap, and it kills much more expensive stuff. So let's take a look at that. Okay, let's begin by start moving it before we spawn anything in. I don't want to go very up. As we spawn a warden in. A warden is a regular on its watch design, and I don't know why it's up there. I think it might have spawned on top of a mountain? Yeah, torpedoes are not going to reach there. No. Fail. Destroy that. let's place it somewhere else. Let's see if the other spawn east. It's in the water. Not quite sure. Yeah, it's in the water. Okay, the problem is, I think we have just fired the torpedoes. The thing is, it's just behind a landmass, so I don't really know, but... Well, the torpedoes should be able to reach there. Let's try this. Okay, the first important thing is I'm using full manual controls here. I have an AI setup in case you want to fight with the AI, but the AI is quite predictable. And there go our second round of missiles, or rather torpedoes. The AI is quite predictable, and in order to keep this thing from being hit, each time you see the enemy fire, you have to turn. You have to turn in a drastic correction to force the enemy cells, as you can see, to fall in a place when you are where you are no longer at. Because if I have discovered something about crank cannons, is that you might think, well, they are very slow, they are not going to hit. If you change course and you are far enough, they are not going to hit. But if you don't change course, they are going to hit. So, sadly, in this battle, you are not going to be able to see how I... Okay, close. How I follow the torpedoes up to the target and how they blow up. You are going to see me avoiding shots all the time. And there we have some nice land jumping torpedoes. That's really great. We are connecting hits, by the way. I saw some EMP blue telltales going off. But... the only hint we are going to get that what we are doing is working is when that thing dies. Because EMP does no structural damage. EMP, the... Okay, this is going to miss by a wide shot. You can see it's time the enemy fires, I'm changing course. And now, as he fires, I'm going to do a... As you can see, a turn towards him. Shoot the torpedoes, keep the turn. There, he fired, but as we are turning, it's going to miss and start trying to put back some distance. Yeah, EMP does no structural damage. EMP sends a very strong signal on electricity conducting, electricity conducting the material, that means metal mostly. And light alloys, and if that signal reaches a mainframe, it damages it directly. Okay, we avoided that one. So we won't see the enemy ship blowing up, We won't see pieces of it falling off. We won't see huge explosions. Ooh, I almost rolled there. As you can see, this is what I told you. If you are going in one direction and you start the turn immediately in the other, you have to be very careful. Because the ship almost rolled out of the water. Ooh, that was close. Well, the idea is that EMP also destroys not only mainframes, it also destroys local weapon controllers, they destroy detection equipment, that kind of high-tech stuff. So I was hoping to, well, slap some local weapon controllers and make him not fire all his guns at the same time, but it seems I'm not achieving it. Because that thing is still fighting all the time. Okay. Time for another full turn as we pass the nose on his bearing. We fire, we keep the turn. And this is how this thing is supposed to fight. It's very fast, so let's use that speed. It's fast and slow, both. Okay, those are going to hit by a mile. Good. Now we are going directly away from him. That way, when he fires, I only have to do a simple turn and those cells shouldn't fall in the same postcode as my ship. And they didn't. The farther you are, the safer you are. And these torpedoes essentially have infinite range for what regards to this kind of engagements, with two fuel tanks and two torpedo propellers that component that increases the life by 3 minutes of the torpedoes. Yeah, they have a huge range. So we have to keep on avoiding. I'm seriously sorry, guys, that I can't really try to focus that ship and take a look at the damage that's going on, if any, at any time. But this is how this ship has to be fought. If I miss one turn when the enemy fires and those cells fall on me, they are going to essentially put me into low orbit, or high orbit actually, because those ground cannons are really powerful. And this ship is made of wood. The only metal I have in there are a couple of beams, some lead on the bottom, and the light alloys covering the ammo spaces. But okay, fired again, turn again. Again, this is a ship to use in manual control. The AI wouldn't do this as good at all. Maybe if there was some way to induce the AI to do constant zigzagging, it would work very well. But as it is, it's very hard to set it to do zigzags. It's impossible. You might use, I think, Lua code to write an AI that does that, but I have no clue about how to write Lua code. And anyway, Lua is very resource intensive, and yeah. As I said in my last video, I don't have the best computer ever, so anything that causes frames to drop, I'm trying to stay away from. Fire incoming, we duck and fire back, and keep the turn to keep the range. Another shot incoming. Oh, there we go. AI dead. That's what we were waiting for. We didn't see any huge explosions. The enemy ship had no structural damage, but we killed its AI. And that's what a constant barrage of EMP does. You can see it's already spawning. Let me check that. 80,000 RP. And we destroyed it with a ship that costs less than 10%. I would call that really effective, even while you have to use it in manual control mostly. Yeah, this thing works like a charm. It's a problem. The problem comes when you try to fight something with advanced cannons. Then, yeah, because advanced cannons fire at much faster cell muzzle velocities, and yeah, avoiding is less effective. But even against those, thanks to the speed of those propellers, and thanks to the fact that it's really a stealthy design, They are not accurate enough to kill it, at least not before I have connected several torpedoes on the enemy. And again, this being a cheap ship, it's a ship intended to act in a team of 4 or 5 ships like this. If you lose one or two of them, but you kill the enemy, who cares, right? You killed an enemy 80,000 materials of cost, with losing 2 ships worth 7,000. I will sign it any day. Well, it's obvious to see that when you take a ship that is not really yours, and you make a video out of it, you feel a little bit guilty, but I don't think I should, I don't know. At any rate, this thing I really wanted to showcase, because the basic design was brilliant, I loved it. So, yes, putting some weapons on it doesn't make it mine at all. So the ship is still that guns. So, yeah, I'll put a link down in the description to the original post so you can see how the whole thing went. And credit for him, because this ship is his. I only slapped some torpedoes on it. So, well, I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and see you later.